Okay, we got a 2012 Toyota Corolla. We are installing an amplifier, which is the and a SCAR audio speaker, a single SCAR 10. Oh, that's an 8. That's not even a 10. Yes, and a an amplifier, which is right here. I think he bought a single amplifier with the let me open this up. It's a Kenwood 1000 watts, the KAC-511. It does have the base knob controller, so that's what we're gonna have to do, hook that up too. A lot of time we forgot to hook it up, and then we had to take it off and hook it up again. So here we go. The customer brought in the four gauge wiring kits. That's all his. So we're gonna take a flathead and poke a hole through up there, through the rubber boot up there. And we're gonna run this wire right here, this four gauge. We're gonna run around here so it don't get caught on this steering wheel right here. So we're gonna pull this wire out and going up there. When I say up there, it's all the way up passing the on top of the brake. We cannot record that, so it's kind of hard. We'll show you later. And here we got the four gauge out here on where the engine is at. This is the battery is on the driver's side front. So see the wire right there that we ran earlier? We're gonna make sure the we're gonna have to fix this. I think the customer did it himself right here. Did the customer did it himself too? Because the wire is sticking out. Sticking out of the fuse holder. Did you do that? Okay. So yeah, we're gonna take this out and make sure this wire is all the way in. We don't want this wire to touch any metal around here. Gonna get a short or smoking. So I'm gonna redo that part later. Yeah. Okay, so what we got right now is the power wire. It ran like so on the top, and then run it straight right here down, and then we are hooking up the the remote wire right here, so we can hook it up to the fuse down here. We'll show you which fuse you need to hook it up to. And then we're gonna pop this open right here. Pop it open, pop this open. We're gonna put the four gauge wire right there. Put it back in and right here. And we have to hook up the base knob controller also. We're gonna leave it long enough. We're gonna leave it to the customer about right there. We don't wanna screw anything to their car until they say, okay, you can do that. So we're gonna keep it like that for them. And then run the wire up here and down here. So we got this run. And then right here, this part right here, you don't have to take this whole thing off if you don't want to. I mean, it's just making more work. All you have to do is move the seat forward, and then you take a like a flat head or something, push it like this, and snuck it in. Like so. See? I just do it one hand. And oh, by the way, I'll show you right here. Okay, right here, just push this seat belt down a little bit and start from here. Remember, this is a small car, it's hard to move too. I'm not a professional at videoing, so probably notice that. So I'm using one hand, trying to shove this power and stuff in. Make sure the small wire, which is the remote wire, I have my assistant helping me out here like that. Actually, I'm gonna let him finish it right here. too, right here. Yep. So, like I said, don't leave the remote wire on the bottom because it's gonna fall off somehow. Eventually, so got that back up, and then keep running the wire under the seat right here, and snuck it in right there. He's gonna show. Do it, so this is what it's gonna look like. Grab that seat down like that, like that. We're gonna put the amp right here. Now I'm at the back, so he sand this thing. You can use a sander, you can use the anything you can clean. You got to clean this all the way to the bare metal right there. You can use the flathead and just rubbing it, or sandpaper. Now what's he doing? He's ran the ground wire, the 4 gauge. He's gonna strip that. He's gonna put the spade terminal, because we just don't shove the wire right here. It's too big. That's one of ours, right, Tune?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because you see they don't give it.
I don't know why.
A lot of amplifier like that. Cause they don't want to spend that money, so you have to buy the spade terminal for a smaller amp.
So tight.
What is this thing? What is this black thing right here? Oh, yeah, you didn't.
Why. Yeah, you didn't get that, did you?
Get what?
All that.
All what?
All the excess wire.
So he's gonna crimp that. Gotta put some force. So make sure that don't come off. You kind of pull it a little bit, make sure everything is tight. And you do the power the same way too. But usually we don't hook up the power yet until everything is done. That way. Down. Put this down. Take it off. Oh, shit. Okay,
about?
Go ahead. Like this, too. It make it look prettier. You try to put it down because it looks nicer like this. A lot of time, a lot of amplifier, you don't have to use this. It's got a hole, and you just push it right in. So that remote wire right here that he got, he's gonna put it right here. Actually, I'm gonna run it for him real quick. Got the remote wire done. Now he's gonna hook up the high-low converter, which is the Kicker brand. And now we are hooking up the high-low converter. We actually, this time we kind of changed your routine a little bit. We put the high-low converter down here, and we'll run the RCA jack up to the amplifier over there. So what we did, we hook up the white black, gray black together to the to the negative side, which is, you know, the speaker wire. You have a black and red, it'd be the negative, the black side's the negative, and then the the white and gray is probably positive. We're gonna hook it up to the red wire, which is positive side of the speaker. So now this thing does got a built-in remote output. We're not gonna use it this time. We're just gonna hook it up over there. That way it won't make any crazy noise. You know, when you turn the key on, start the car, it make this thumping noise. You don't want that. So cluttering noise. So we are hooking up that, and then we ran the wire up here to the speakers. The customer already had the aftermarket radio, so it's easy to tell which one's positive. As you can see right here, white is positive and white black is negative. So you're gonna hook up the red to the white, and then the black to the white black, which is negative. Or let's say if you can see they hide the wire up there. So you cannot see what color the wire if you have a factory radio, factory speakers. So what it is, I found out that the black wire is positive and the yellow wire is negative if you have a factory wire that's still hooking up to this factory speakers right here, because this is an aftermarket. So basically black is positive, yellow is negative. So here at the end, we hooked up everything already. We got that white as a remote. I'm going to show you how I hook it up, where the fuse is at and what side. We got the speaker wire, which is positive right here, and then the negative right there. And then we got the base knob controller and the RCA jacks already hooked up. There's also, if you really want to, you can hook this one up for the high-low converter, but I don't like it because it's not that powerful. I mean, you want the kicker version, which is KISLOC 1, KISLOC 1. So, and he's got the speaker hooked up, and usually we'll ask the customer if they wanted to mount on. We charge a little bit extra, but it's up to the customer on that part right there. And then I'm gonna go back to the front. Now here's a tricky part about this one right here. You can use a regular fuse, but this one is the fuse that came with it. So what I did, I stripped this wire a little bit, just keep a couple because it doesn't require that much power to turn on the amp. So okay, so now I got this wire sticking out like this. So I'm putting this fuse, because it's tricky right here, you just put a little bit right there. Don't put it too much, it's hard to push it in. Now I'm gonna put it on number 24 fuse, which is accessory basically. Be looking at like this on the pin 24, on number 24, you can see it right there. And you want it to towards the side of the engine side, because what happened if there's a short somewhere, it will pop that 7.5 fuse. But if you put it on the opposite side, which is the my side, the back side, it's gonna burn something else instead of popping the fuse. So this is where you want it at, on pins on number 24, right next to the 15s. I'm making sure that I can adjust it a little bit for them. I cannot turn it on, play the music, because YouTube is strict about that. I'm gonna turn it up about 3/4 away, and then make sure this is the on position. Oops. Turn the input sensitivity to about 3/4, bass boost to half, and the low pass frequency to, they should leave it on the middle already, so we might be good. But yeah, about less than 3/4, and then the amp is on. Now we're waiting for music. Mention power wire. See, basically the power wire that whoever that they ran it from the factory or whatever, there shouldn't be any copper or anything sticking out like that. We want to make sure everything is clean right here, so it doesn't touch any metal. And then hooking that to the positive side, this is a 1/2 inch, unscrew it and push it in there. It just show you that you don't want to put this power wire right here on top, because this, as you can see right here, this seat belt right here. So you're gonna see all this wire. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna put it underneath the seat belt instead.